Certain CEOs will soon pave the way to sustainability, as well as to human thriving, while at the same time efficiently solving whatever climate challenges we are confronting now. In our view, the most essential challenge of humans, and this by far, will be the degeneration of 90% of agricultural soils worldwide, as it is foreseen by scientists and certain others, by the year 2050, which is only 15 years from now. The then obvious consequential lack of affordable food worldwide, obviously will aggravate all tensions, divisions, and conflicts. We clearly see this unedited and extremely fast soil degeneration as a direct challenge to human existence, as well as that of many animals of the world. Surprisingly, most people are not even well aware of the fact of soil degeneration, its importance, nor of the inevitable impacts. Consumption as usual seems to make most humans blind to the above, and no one seems to have interest in making them aware of the above. A number of mainly younger humans sees what they believe to be a by scientific consensus pointed out rise of global temperatures as the main or even exclusive challenge of all humans. But another probably more significant number of humans sees a lack of economic thriving and its consequences as a main challenge for themselves, their countries, and eventually the whole world. Resuming, there are important divisions, and possibly partly because of them few give enough attention to the quickly nearing essential challenge of 8 billion humans only disposing of 10% of their agricultural land for food production, by or before the year 2050. If calamities also will increase, as seems to be the case, the future challenges will become even more important and challenging. Few seem to see the obvious association between this by us mentioned quick degeneration of productive agricultural land on one hand, with both the rise in temperatures, as well as the decrease of thriving, on the other hand. Interestingly, the richest CEOs of the world see national debts as one of the greatest challenges. They see artificial intelligence and robots as the only way out. While this is an almost obvious solution, at least for the CEOs' industries, as well as for the lack of economic thriving, the same richest CEOs of the world are well aware of the also since long foreseen lack of resources, and that also includes fossil fuels. We see carbon agroforests the best way to go, as the best solution for all 8 billion humans, simply because A. Carbon agroforests will stop and even reverse the progressing and seemingly unstoppable degradation of soils. B. Carbon agroforests will make all countries and all humans thrive in the most important senses. C. Last but not least, carbon agroforests will regulate the temperature of cities and eventually of the planet, inclusively will also remove all post-industrial carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. Regarding robots, artificial intelligence, as well as income and dignity for all humans, the development of carbon agroforests, with their 100-fold production, will provide all this. At the same time, carbon agroforests quickly will cause the demise of all large, expensive and soil-compacting agricultural machines, this in total favor of many lightweight robots that will operate and harvest even in the canopies of the carbon agroforests, this so even without roads. These robots, including their artificial intelligence, will need to be operated, or at least assisted by people operating and assisting them from their homes all across the world. That will provide income, independency, and dignity for all humans. Possibly at this point, many will claim that CEOs would have taken action already, if they would be open for this by us proposed carbon agroforest-based action plan and economy, with its multiple and beneficial combination of A. Restoring degenerated soils. B. Solving all climate challenges. C. Making humans thrive without the need of ever more debt, and without the dependence on further increasing of the already unsustainable spending and consumption. But the above claim that CEOs would have taken action already, if they would have been open for this by us proposed carbon agroforest-based action plan and economy, is not true. Possibly and partly because pseudoscientists, at least in this particular case, like Bill Gates, and to some extent also influencers like Sabine Hossenfelder, systematically misled or distracted all humans regarding this subject, and that also includes certain CEOs that otherwise would have been open for the plan, and would have already invested in, and would already have sustained such a carbon agroforests action plan and economy. After all, the carbon agroforest economy needs and consequently demands the robots and artificial intelligence the CEO see as the general solution. Also to remove all post-industrial carbon dioxide, or fossil carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. We claim that these CEOs, and especially Musk, will be the easiest and one of the first to jump on the carbon agroforest and the collateral related climate challenges solution bandwagon, and possibly do so in the blink of an eye. After all, they, as most humans, had very little contact with the subject and potential of carbon agroforests. We claim that with the CEOs on the wagon, or supporting the carbon agroforest economy or the action plan, it would become much easier for all the rest that matters to also jump on or support carbon agroforests. The reasons we see for CEOs, and especially Musk, to have interest and play an important role in the action plan are multiple. And amongst others, A. Musk, but also other important CEOs and authorities totally voluntarily awarded important, mostly significant money prizes related to providing a solution to remove carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. What is so special about carbon agroforest is that this removal is not something that must be done and will cost, but that the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere will become the building block of all they and all humans need and consequently need to harvest out of the atmosphere. Moving something is a burden, and harvesting something clearly is beneficial. B. Important CEOs and even authorities have interest, and invested lots of time and money in safe havens for themselves, certain elites, or eventually all humans. C. Musk, but also other important CEOs and authorities are interested in and in fact need the guarantees that only these carbon agroforests can offer, and this in abundance, of all that their industries or what they represent need, and that goes from a wide range of resources like from abundant and healthy food for all humans, and all basic materials, all fuels and energies, to all essential and all rare resources, even so abundant and high quality graphene, as well as all rare earth metals, etc. To be clear, carbon agroforests provide all metals, and all rare earth metals without mines, without mining, and also without pollution, and this totally sustainable. This is the subject of other videos. Musk, but also other important CEOs and authorities are aware that A. We soon will also run out of mineral oil, gas, and coal. B. We soon will also run out of affordable essential resources that are provided by mines and mining. At least that is the case without carbon agroforests. When these CEOs and authorities will become aware of the unedited potential and guarantees of carbon agroforests, including the clear potential to sustainably provide all they and we 8 billion humans need, this including fuels and all resources, including rare resources, they will not hesitate and fully go for it, simply because they know they cannot afford to not go for this unedited opportunity. So are we all done? And will we thrive and solve all from now on? Yes, we are. But only after the attention of these CEOs is drawn to the full potential and all guarantees that carbon agroforests offer them and their industries. The coming COP30 international event that starts on 10th of November in Belém, Brazil, is a good and perhaps unique opportunity, or else a good starting point for this initiative and action plan related to carbon agroforests. Assisting and comprehending the potential of this video and the video at the end is as important, and probably the most important. In case you like the here proposed initiative or action plan, or carbon forest economy, or the information in this video, please subscribe to this channel, leave a comment, question, or a like on this video. This video and other useful videos of this channel are translated and or dubbed in over 5 languages, this for this initiative and plan to succeed, and to unite humans across the world, at least in this for all 8 billion humans essential action plan.